Hello, it is Monday, the 3rd of April, and I'm late for work. I was catching up on my good friend Rachel's YouTube videos because I really have been so busy I don't have much time to watch YouTube these days, and then I got distracted and now I'm late for work, but I'll link her channel in the description as usual. She has such a wonderful channel. I love the energy she has in her videos. I love hearing about all the different worlds of books that she's into that I am, you know, unfamiliar with. It allows me to experience them a little bit through her. But anyways, she has such a wonderful and uplifting channel, and definitely check her out. And also, my friend Julia has just started a YouTube channel herself, and she's already made wonderful content, lifestyle type videos. I'll link her in the description as well. Today is Wednesday, the 5th of April. Just got home from work. It's about 4:45. I also stopped at the library and got a couple new books for my reading challenge. All right, it's Wednesday now. I was trying to make a like week in the life sort of vlog video, but I filmed pretty much every time I was really able to, and clearly it was not very much, so I really can't make much of a video out of that. But I decided yesterday I went to the library and got a few books for the suggestions reading challenge I'm doing. So I figured I'd talk about my spring TBR because I felt inspired to do so. So this might be a bit ambitious for me because I really don't know how much time I'm going to have. But then once I was getting all the books accumulated that I wanted to read, I was like, okay, maybe I have too much ideas. First things first, I'm reading the Odyssey. I actually started it yesterday because I just read the Iliad, obviously, and this is the next the next move. I'm very excited for this, actually, because it's always really intrigued me, the whole 10-year sea journey. So I'm very excited to read this. Because of the Odyssey, another book that I don't actually have right now that I want to read is The Fall of Troy by Quintus Smyrnaeus. Probably not how you say his name, but the Iliad just like cuts you off right at the end of the Trojan War, so I want to know how it all wraps up in detail, so that's another one I want to read along with the Odyssey. This book I've been reading for a while because, you know, in the Sherlock Holmes books, this is the Return of Sherlock Holmes, there's like 10 different short stories within, well, in the three volumes, The Adventures, The Return, and The Memoirs. There's like 10 different stories in each book, and I have one left in this book, so I want to finish that probably in a couple weeks, so I'll read the last one. This is a book I also started briefly called Everyday Grace by Marianne Williamson. I really want to get this done in the next 2 weeks. It'll probably take me a couple days once I really start reading it, but I just really haven't had time to pour into any books. But the book's about having hope, finding forgiveness, and making miracles. So that's a simple way to put it, but it's just about how to live a better Christian life, I believe. So I haven't read any mysteries since like autumn, so I really have been wanting to, but there's more books I need to get out of the way first before I can do more of the pleasure reading. But I want to read this. My brother got our family for Christmas, called The Floating Admiral. It's by Agatha Christie, one of my favorite mystery writers, but it's also by Dorothy Sayers and G.K. Chesterton. They like collaborated to make this, so it should be very interesting. I'm very excited to read this. I want to read this very soon. I might just read it like one weekend coming up. And then another mystery I want to read. This is a collection of Agatha Christie, Miss Marple novels, and I've read three of these, I believe, but I want to read the next one called What Mrs. McGillicuddy Saw. So that's another mystery I want to read. This is all stuff I probably want to read before June, basically. I've been wanting to read The Hobbit again for a while because I read it last winter, spring, and I read it every year. I'm really wanting to read it again, but I'm trying to put it off so that I can get more books out of the way first. But I want to read this. I'll probably start it after Easter, maybe in a week or two. But I absolutely love this edition of it. It's illustrated by Jemima Catlin, and it's incredible. This is one of my favorite books that I own. It's a beauty. Also, for the two books I got from the library yesterday are for the reading challenge. One of them is Moby Dick, so that will be fun. But this is actually, it shouldn't be that hard to read, I don't think. We'll see. People say it's boring, but I should be able to do it, I hope. So this has got to be read in the next few weeks, as well as Dracula by Bram Stoker, another suggestion, which I'm actually very excited to read this. I feel like it would be better to read it around Halloween, but nevertheless, I think I'm really going to enjoy this, and I'm very excited to read this too. I also bought this book recently called The Hidden Life of Trees. I really want to read this since, you know, it's very related to spring and summer. So it's just a detailed book about the life of trees and how they grow and affect the world and communicate with the world and communicate with each other. I also want to read A Wrinkle in Time by Madeleine L'Engle. I've never read it before, but I know it's a very popular book, and I saw it on the shelf, and I was like, you know what, I might as well just read this, because why not? It looks like a fun thing to read. That's another one. I also want to read Treasure Island by Robert Louis Stevenson. I've never read it before, but I've always loved this story, you know, growing up, so I'm actually very excited to read this as well. I feel like it's a good thing to read in spring, summer. Another book I don't have is Caravelle by Stephanie Garber. That was recommended to me by my friend Rachel, and I'm very excited to read that as well. I'm not sure if I'm going to buy it or get it from the library, but that'll be another one I'll try to squeeze in. And then lastly is the Bible. This is the Bible is the last friend-suggested book that I need to read. Obviously, I really can't say whether or not I'll be able to do this or not, like, in a quick fashion, I mean, because it's, I think the Bible is like 1,200 pages, so, I don't know if I'll be able to read it fast or not. I highly doubt I'll be able to fit this in if I'm reading all this other stuff, I mean, completely, but, we'll see, I'll get through it, hopefully, within a few months. That's all that I currently have planned. I probably won't get through half of it, but that's kind of the point of TBRs, I guess, is to set yourself, you know, goals, whether you can achieve them or not, at least you have them. And it does help for motivation and ideas, and like having a goal really helps me to read more, actually, because I'm like so much more aware of like I need to read this and get it done by this certain amount of time. If I don't have any goals, then I just kind of read whatever I want whenever I want, and I don't get as much done. So this is my spring TBR minus two books, and wish me luck, guys, because I'm gonna need it. See ya.